15.
Falling over here.
We're having an awful.
It's every time you jump like that.
Yes,
you make a bit of wind on it.
Happened in Australia. Yes. Does it upset you or the boys? Do you feel that you suffer because of this?
Oh, you don't suffer. We're bound to be a bit less healthy than people who breathe air. I mean, there's so many good things, you know, to make up for it. Who's moaning?
Me. Now, when this tour's over, then you'll have a bit of a chance to get out and get some air, as you say, with your family.
I'm not sure, you see, because it's when the tour finishes, we go back and do the premiere of the film. It's one of those periods that Brian says, I'm not quite sure what we've got. And it all sort of fills up gradually with TV and radio. So.
Now, you mentioned Brian. I was going to mention it. How did you get... How did you get associated with Brian Epstein? And how much do you feel you owe him?
Well, we owe him 1 and 6, exactly. But we owe a lot of our success to him, you know, a great deal.
Yes.
Because I think we might have been able to make hit records, because we would have written the songs anyway. Mm. This one's run out, and but we wouldn't have gone, we wouldn't have, he controlled us, you see. Anybody that tried to manage us earlier on couldn't get through to us, you know. They'd last about a week, and we'd say, we're not having you.
So yeah, he's more or less gotten you and taken full control.
Yes, but he didn't take over, as some people do, right, as if he just sort of walked in and said, right, cut your hair like that, put this suit on, any of that, you know. Mm. We're already there, but he just sort of, people sort of said we were dirty, well, we weren't dirty, we were just in jeans because we couldn't afford anything else, you know.
A lot of people have said that Epstein has emerged as a genius of show business. Do you agree with this?
Well, I'm a bit odd, you know, I don't like using the word genius, but there's so many geniuses on LP covers and things like that, that I think he's done more than anybody expected him to do, which entitles people that don't know what's happening to call him a genius. He's very good. I wouldn't say he's a genius.
I want to ask you one direct personal question. Is he a friend?
Oh, definitely. You see, we can't get on with anybody for a long time unless they are a friend, because we're so closely knit.
Well, I've noticed this with the others in your entourage.
Mm.
How many of them are really very close to you?
Well, Neil, he's our personal road manager. Well, he was in from the start. He went to school with Paul and George. And the other fellow, Derek, we've known for about a year. But he's sort of one of those people that clicked as soon as you meet him, you know. So that, and Malcolm, we've known from the cabin. He used to, he carries the guitars round, you know, and all that. Well, he used to work at the cabin, a big bouncy, throwing all the teddy boys out.
Well, John, I've said it 100 times already to you, but I hope you have happy memories of your Australian trip when you get home and can think about it.
Thank you, Malcolm. We will do.
Thank you for your time.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Hello, Barry Farber. How about playing on his record? This is the Beatles speaking.
Here we go.